Greetings, my brothers and sisters. Peace be with you. Welcome to my Papal Chamber of Relaxation. I hope that you are doing well. All are welcome here, no matter if you are a vampire, skeleton, werewolf, ghoul, goblin. It does not matter. For if you are suffering with stress, anxiety, panic attacks, PTSD, depression, and much more, all because of the humans, then it is my job as Lord Precept of the Undead to help bring you some comfort, some solace in these most dire times. So, I am going to perform the ancient rite of ASMR to help you find peace of mind. Is that okay? Good. So, without any further delay, we are going to begin. First, I am just going to check your vital organs to make sure they are functioning or not functioning properly, depending on the type of species, creature that you are. So just stay put, my friend, and let me prepare. Now, you are probably wondering, why does his papal lordship perform such methods? Please breathe in deeply. If you do not have internal organs, you can just skip this part. Breathe in deeply and exhale. Good. Breathe in and exhale. Excellent. Again, breathe in and exhale. And now I'm just going to listen to your heart. if you have one. Okay. Excellent. As I was saying, I made it my I guess goal, if you will, to make sure that I bring peace to all of my creature, monster, and undead brothers and sisters during these times when humans wish nothing but to harm us and ill will. So I like to go the extra mile, if you will, and perform some very basic cursory health exam so that I know what I'm dealing with, so I know how to properly treat you. Okay? Okay. I'm just going to check one more thing. Just want to check your blood pressure. If you have it, just put your arm in here. Excellent. Let me just tighten this up a little bit. It's not easy being in my position. Okay. All right. Up, there we go. Let's get this here. All right. Gonna check this out. Alright, excellent. I must say, you have a clean bill of health. Yeah. Okay. Now, I'm just going to perform a little eye exam again. This is mostly if you have eyes. Okay. So, I just need you to follow the light. Okay, I'm just gonna stand over here and perform this. Okay, this procedure here. Okay. All right. I just want you to follow the light. I hope that the humans haven't been mistreating you. Okay, you're doing great there. Just keep that up. I just want to make sure that your eyes are functioning properly, okay? Alright. You're doing great. There we go. Okay. I hope this is, do you like this? I use it to get around the Vatican at night when I want a midnight snack. I found this over at some strange human shop. There was a dead human on the floor, half eaten. So, score one for the good guys. And on the outside it said, what was the name of it? Yeah, it said zombies. Yeah, how did you know? Have you been there? Interesting. But I saw this. I thought this would be kind of useful, you know? After I scooped up the remains of Zed and brought him to the Vatican for all the archbishops and cardinals to have a nice feast. Great for a lot of purposes, a multi-use tool. Yeah. Can even brush your face. What do you think about that? It's pretty neat. It's pretty swell. See that? Just like that. Happy little brush strokes. Yeah. Your face there is a little dry. Probably dehydrated. But not a problem. I'll take care of you. So anyway, yeah, a nice, I don't think I ever would have thought of something like that. Okay. So. Seem a little parched, so. I'm just gonna, you wanna listen to that? It's a nice sound. I always like the sound of bottle caps myself. There we go. How about this side? There's something very calming and pleasing to the auditory nerves. Comes to gentle sounds of various objects that is the magic of ASMR. Some say it was first discovered and named after the Arkham Sanitarium for mental rehabilitation. An old human. I don't know what you want to say. Facility. Run by the great, great Professor Clemens. Without him, I don't think we would be here today. I hope you like that. By the way, you can call me Frank. Last name's Walker. They really wanted me to take the name of Pope Francis, but it sounds a little pretentious, if you ask me. And I want to be more down-to-earth. Undead ruler. So, Frank, it is. Okay. Here you go. You can have some of this to drink. There you go. I knew you were thirsty. Oh, what's in it? Oh, secret formula. If I was to tell you, well, then everybody would be Pope. Okay, let's see what else we got here for you. Oh, yeah. You're probably hungry, too, aren't you? Okay. Get you something to eat. And then we'll get into that nitty-gritty. This secret recipe. It is a favorite. Of all the cardinals and archbishops. Just to stir this up real good for you. Delicious, huh? Yeah, I knew you'd like that. Made only of the finest. ingredients that you'll find here in the scorched earth. Just listen to that. Forget the other ear. Okay. Let's get that to feeding you. There you go. You like that? Good stuff. There you go. Okay. Open up wide. There you go. I knew you liked that. Take good care of my brothers and sisters in need . What the humans do to us is simply deplorable . So there you go. I knew you were hungry and thirsty. Definitely could use some good Papal sustenance. There you go. Eat. Eat, my friend. Yes. More. Soon you will feel vigor, vitality restored. And if you are a magic-wielding creature, this will restore your mana, too. Okay. Is that good? Okay. Great. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed that. Okay. What I'm gonna do now is spray you with some unholy water and perform the cleansing of the damned. Okay? Sound good? Okay. Again, this will help restore your flesh, your bones, whatever you might be made out of. Okay? So, I'm just gonna there we go. Yeah, you sure look like you could use it, that's for sure. feel it. Power of the unholy water. It's quite powerful. How does that make you feel, huh? I only want to help you to find some peace of mind and relaxation. It's true. I know these times may be tough on you, my friend, but that is why Undead Pope is here for you to help you rejuvenate, to help you find solace and peace from the humans and their relentless torment and pain that they cause upon us. So, just let me help you, okay? And you will feel better very soon, I promise. Okay. Now, for this next bit of relaxation, this method, I'm going to cleanse the room and perform an ancient rite of an unholy blessing, okay? So, just bear with me. I just want to get this. Do it again here. Be a little difficult. We'll get this puppy going here. Pretty short. Starts to burn. cast some little pieces of resin. You may enjoy the sound of this. We will use this to cleanse, to perform the ancient ritual of the dead. Cleanse the air, cleanse your body and your mind. Okay. I don't know if that's still burning. Take a look. I think it went out. These are tricky son of a gun. See if we can light the edge here. Little tricky. Oh, I think we got it. Yeah, we got it. We got this. There we go. Yeah. Okay. Yep, it's burning now. Well, it's lit. It's not burning, but... Okay. So we're gonna let that, that charcoal just... cook. Okay. Alright, I'm sorry. Be right there with you. Okay. So as I said, I had these little pieces of resin, and I'll use this. Sounds, huh? So beautiful. So relaxing. I performed these same ancient rites on my fellow cardinals and archbishops of the dead. Here. Just gonna sprinkle some right onto the coal. Then we'll put the top of it on here. Okay. There we go. See? get this untangled here. There we go. I think that's good. Okay. Now, you just have to imagine that I am performing a rite where you are, this ancient rite. We're having a little technical difficulty here. Okay, there we go. Okay. Korachi no korota. Korata saru. Korata. These rites will chase away any of the evil human spirits that may try to possess you, your body, and your mind. In this rite will sanctify this room so that this session between you and I will appease terrible lords. that rule over us all. The old ones. He who lies dreaming. That should take care of the blessing. Seal the air. The presence is more unholy than it has ever been. And you should begin to feel more. So I was saying, excuse me, you should begin to feel more at peace. Your mind of all the terrible things that the humans have made you witness and hear. Okay? These are the unholy salts. They contain the screams of our undead creature and monster brothers and sisters who have left this world. It is the salt of their tears, the salt of their blood, and it will help you to relax. There. Can you hear the screams? Can you hear the wails of terror? The cries of release as they suffered a cruel and horrible fate at the hands of the humans. The human species. Well, I can't complain all too much. I wouldn't be here if I wasn't a human in my past life. But humans have not learned how to face their fears. And it is their fear of the unknown, their fear of death, which drives them to do the horrible things that they do, not only to us, but to themselves. Find this relaxing. I hope so, my friend. That's my job. As the supreme unholy leader of the undead. Soothing sounds, the dried salt of tears from our undead creature monster brothers and sisters who are no longer with us. I just want you to relax. That's it. That's it. Allow the unholy salts to penetrate deep within your mind. Allow the torment screams of our sorely missed brothers and sisters to chase away all your worries and problems and take you into a faraway, peaceful place. And I will grind tears. Lies within you that you have kept up, bottled like a genie in a bottle. Now, and I will just perform this very personal ancient rite of healing, cleansing, using nothing more than an old ancient dialect that is only full of positive affirmations. Massage your scalp as I do this. Yeah. unholy scalp massage. Helps even calm the most troubled of heart and mind. If you have a heart, that is. Okay. Now I have this human item. I'm not sure what it is. Soothing. It makes for such a pleasant sound. Earlier, when I was speaking, facing your fears, in regards to humans, and how the humans are so terrible with their primal hate, anger for everything on this scorched, forsaken rock. Well, some of us, including you, have to face our fears as well, and I'm going to help you do that here once I'm done. The only way to find true peace of mind is to face yourself, to look yourself in the mirror, unless you're vampire and such, or Medusa. Definitely don't want to look in the mirror if you're Medusa. Stone yourself. That's not very conducive of a healthy existence. But I digress. Join those crinkly sounds. I love crinkly sounds. So wonderful. So calming. Would you agree, my friend? I knew you. I just want you to feel at peace. And all the fears of being chased and hunted and killed, burned by the humans, just disappear. And listen to the unholy package of soothing. Curious unholy package of soothing of great, I forget what I called it, doesn't really matter. Just listen. Yeah. Wonderful. Now, gonna move on to something else. As I said earlier, you want to face your fears so that you can learn how to overcome them, how to evolve to reach your fullest potential. And here I have one of the greatest fears that many of my undead creature and monster brothers and sisters fear. But you see, this machete is harmless. Unless in the hands of someone who would wish to use it to cause harm. Say, my brothers and sisters, it is not a weapon. It is not the machete. It is not the words. It is not the book. It is not the torches, the wooden stakes, the silver bullet. They cannot hurt you. It is whomever is behind them. So you must learn to face your fear. Because this machete can also be a tool. To be used for good. Empower yourself. That is what you must do. Ownership of the machete. Become the machete, the wooden stake, the silver bullet. Only when you have faced your fear . Next, I have a treat for you, which I think you'll enjoy. Relaxing monster hands. Don't worry. No monster was harmed in the making of these. the monster whose hands these once belonged to was a captain in Thousand Year War. Centuries ago, a great leader. Served under the first Clemens Regiment. If you weren't aware of that, Professor Clemens unleashed chaos into the world without that human. Well, we would not be here, as I said. And his creation served him well, as it serves us now, in part. If you ever travel west, cross the great crater, across the bone desert to what was once known as the Atlantic Ocean. If you travel through the tormenting swamps and come to the great forsaken land, you may find the old Arkham Sanitarium still standing. Many unruly, undead creatures, monsters that do not wish to face their fears, that live in fear. They reside there. It is not a safe place, for they are our tormented brothers and sisters who have no hope of being saved, and they will exercise extreme prejudice on both humans and their own kind. Some say that your life of death still dwells there. We thought your life of death would be our savior, but it is not the case. We will speak no more of that. This is a time for peace, not for becoming upset and worried. Speaking of Cthulhu, I have some Cthulhu blocks. Thought you might like this. Have a nice, pleasant sound. These might even belong to your thought of death once upon a time. Actually, I think these are the ones that open up the gate for the deep ones to come, the old ones to come through during the Thousand Year War. They had since long been extinguished up there. Tower. Quite harmless now. Nothing more than dead wood. Although if you listen closely, you may hear screams of the trees from which these came. But it is not for you to be concerned of. Just let me help you achieve the peace of mind that you seek. Refuge from all that torments you. The humans. One day, the humans will be themselves on the brink of extinction, with their food sources depleted. Just as we are forced to live in the dark. So, one day, will the humans, you can mark my words, 1,000-year war may have ended centuries ago, but its toll, its echoes still linger, reverberate among the ruins, among our minds, forever reminding us of those who wish to eradicate us. But there I go again, getting all worked up. This is supposed to be time of healing. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I hope you enjoy these sounds because I know I do. Such pleasing sounds. Okay. That's gonna do it for the Cthulhu blocks. All right. Last thing I have is wrapping of bubbles. I'm going to wrap this around your head. This is a very old, ancient rite. And then I'm just going to soothe you. Sleep with this. So, I would like to thank you for having me, for joining me. I hope that the unholy lordship was able to bring you some peace of mind. Relaxation and escape from all those who wish to harm you. Now it is time to sleep. Now it is time to rest until you must feed again or hunt. But know that I am here. Peace be with you, my brothers and sisters. Godspeed upon your journey. There we go. There we go. Thank you.